got a fun way to light it. So, let's get to it.
Well, this is how I light big burn piles. My handy dandy flamethrower here. So, let's get it going. I'm thinking that looks pretty good. We'll shoot it right around here. Here we go. Aha! Lit. And I'll go up in there a little bit more and shoot it on in. Like a charm.
Yes.
Burn, baby, burn. Nice about the flamethrower, you can inject it right on down there in the gut of it. Get it going good. Shoot it high too. Uh-huh. Oh, take her bite out of the fun fuel. That should be enough. It's going good over there. And we got it going here. So let's let her burn down. Maybe I'll put y'all in a time lapse. Sounds pretty good. Well, we got the fire going pretty good. Just got to let this burn down for a little while. Make a little hole, and then we'll restack it. It's really taking off on this side. The wind's kind of blowing over here. So, yeah. I'm going to go to restack it. I'll film that too. We're going to use the deer with the rotobeck. A lot of people are going to scream and holler because I put it over the fire, but I've done it many, many, many times. It's just how I do it. But first, let's stoke it up a little more on this side. Here we go. Yes! Burn, baby, burn! Oh, it's getting hot. Alright, that's enough fun for now. We'll come back once it's burned down some. Alright, so we're going across the temporary dam here. Headed over to the burn pile right now. I just dipped the rotobeck in the water a little bit to keep it, get it nice and wet before you put it over the fire. Hurt to do it again. Well, this pond is amazing. cook it on the other side. So we'll let it sit there and cook for a while and burn the center out. Then I'm gonna restack it. All right, that's raging now. It is hot. Well, let's let that go for a few hours. It's cooking. I gotta get out of here. We'll come back. Got everything parked well away from the fire after the last incident that I almost had with the fire jumping over to some pine straw where the woods were, where they were cutting out all that clay. It's burning a fire right there. The wind picked up, and while I was inside for a couple minutes to go get a sandwich, and an ember jumped about 80 feet over, caught the woods on fire. This excavator was parked right over there. There's fire all around it, underneath it. By the time I got to it, I hopped in it, got it out the way, jumped in the dozer, plowed a fire break right here, and had it under control. But yeah, it only took a couple minutes, and set the woods on fire, so I gotta be careful. Smoking a little bit. Let's go dip it in the pond. That was a hot one. Thank you. good about that. Check back in a little while. Trying to get all this burned down in the next 2 days. We can get some clay out of here. At least that's the plan. Stacking. we're going on about 7 hours now, letting this burn down. I'm gonna stir it up one more time. Well, probably a few more times, but I'll set y'all up on a time lapse and we'll watch this disappear.
So as you can tell, that got going pretty good.
And that's not the first time he's a rotovac. He's a rotovac all the time for doing fires like this. It ain't caught on fire yet. When it does start smoking, you gotta dip it in the water. I'm gonna set y'all up on a time lapse so you can watch this disappear. Here we are the next morning. It's mostly burned down. We got to restack it. Got some trees on the back side here. So let's get it cleaned up. Put y'all in the cab because I don't want to run over the camera. Looks like the wind's not really blowing anywhere, it's blowing in a certain direction. So we should go to just pile it up. Let's get the back side first. Stuff on first, so it burns good. fall is here. Halloween's right around the corner. That's a piece of fat light or something. Keep that down low. Now it's stuck. I'm gonna get that off of there. Dirt off. Other side.
with the wind blowing at you. It's a good way to get your machine on fire.
Looks like it's taking off pretty good. Hearing some crackling. Where there's smoke, there's fire. It's about to take off right there. There it goes. So I'm gonna let this burn down for a few hours. Come back and restack it. Well, it's about lunchtime on Sunday. This has been going for about 30 hours now. The majority of everything's burned down. It's got a few logs here and there. I'm gonna restack it and let it burn. Always a good idea that after you're near a fire like that, you give the machine a once over and you look for smoke, you know, just in case an ember got where an ember shouldn't get. And always leave the rotor back out there in case it catches on fire for some reason. But I don't see any smoke on it. Don't see any smoke from the machine. Things are looking good. It's always a good day when you can burn and not burn a machine down. So, well, I'll check back a little later. Well, we did it. The machine is still here. It did not catch on fire. And there is what's left. Let's go look at it. So that big pile of debris has been burned down to a small pile of ashes. There are a few logs burning still. That should be mostly gone by the morning. I would say this was a successful weekend of burning. The weather conditions were just right. And now we could bury this somewhere and dig out a bunch of clay from right here if we need more for the dam. So it's nice that all that's gone. So we shall pick things up a little later. Well, I'll pick things up tomorrow. How about that? Now, I made this video, and I know it's long, but there are some people that, you know, they can't really do much but kind of watch TV. Some people have some medical conditions. Some people are in the hospital. So, kind of made it long just for y'all. Give y'all the full experience. And others that were interested. Well, I hope y'all enjoyed. I hope everybody stays happy and healthy. All right, take care.